Environmental advocates are working to educate some people in New Orleans East about a proposed waste plant. WDSU reporter Simney Chewin is live in Gentilly to tell us what's happening now. And Simney, this has been pretty controversial.
Yeah, Scott, and it's been a controversy that has been at least 2 years in the making. The meeting held at Dillard University should start in just a little more than 2 hours. It's being held by a variety of environmental groups like the Sierra Club, and they say that this proposed plant has numerous health, environmental, and economic impacts, adverse impacts, that is. The technology is called a plasma arc and gasification technology. In short, it's basically a waste-to-energy technology that uses electrical energy and high temperatures to heat waste, which then breaks it down, in turn generating electricity. Now, in that process, as it breaks it down into gas, environmentalists say that hazardous materials are released into the air. This would be the first commercial plant of its kind in the United States. And environmentalists say that folks over in the Northeast, where that proposed plant will be built, say they just do not want to be guinea pigs for this kind of experiment. Scott?
So clearly that's where the controversy comes in. So what does Sun Energy, the group behind this facility, say in response to all this?
Well, Sun Energy is basically heralding the benefits of having this kind of renewable energy plant. They say because all of this waste would be transferred into electricity, they would basically be keeping volumes of waste out of landfills. Because this is a facility that would be built over 65 acres in New Orleans East, they say that it would create 188 permanent jobs, and which would in turn stimulate the economy. Coming up at 5 and 6 o'clock, we will have much more on this controversial plant. Scott, back to you.
All right, 72.